Secondly, is my example. Is my example. Until a few years ago, the best-selling book ever written in the States was a book by a man called Charles Sheldon, and in that book titled In His Footsteps, or In His Steps, millions and millions of people found some profound teaching to radically change their lives. The scripture that inspired and permeated the message of the book is taken from the first book of Peter, chapter 2 and verse 21, which says, Christ suffered for you, leaving you an example that you should follow in his steps. You should follow in his steps. And so Charles Sheldon wrote this book in his steps and just based it from the scripture in 1 Peter 2:21 that you should follow in his steps. He's my Lord and he's also my example. You know, in mathematics and other subjects, when you have an example, it shows you how it's done. And so when you understand the example, you can do any other kind of work similar to that was given to you. You can look at the example. So much easier when you have an example. Jesus is our example. In the upper room, Jesus, their master, their teacher, their Lord, girded himself with a towel and washed his disciples' feet. And what did he say? In John 13 and verse 15, I have given you an example. Here again, he says, I'm giving you an example. He gave us an example of service, where nobody is big and nobody is small, where nobody is insignificant. The biggest should make themselves the smallest. And on the cross, with the blood flowing from his body, Jesus looked at those who were crucifying and he prayed, Father, forgive them. He gave us an example of forgiveness. Can you forgive in that situation? I mean, most of us would rather say, I hope they pay for this. I hope they get caught. I hope this happens to them for what they've done to me. Jesus is giving us an example of what forgiveness is. I read in the paper of a lady just recently who was called upon to identify the killers of her husband. And she said to them on their faces, I forgive you. How many of us can look at killers who killed someone we love so much and say, I forgive you? With the forgiveness that Jesus taught me. You're very quiet. Because that's not easy. But only the grace of God can help you forgive. Only when you look to Jesus as your example can you forgive like this. We are believers and we are following Jesus. We are following in his footsteps. We must forgive. It doesn't matter what they've done. It doesn't matter how badly we've suffered. We must forgive. Christ is our example. And so, dear brothers and sisters, people are not often won to Jesus, I've discovered, just by preaching. No matter how great the preacher is, a few have come to him just on their very own. The majority, I've discovered, have come because someone talked to them personally, one-on-one, about Jesus as Savior and Lord. And so it's so important for us to be good examples so that we can tell everybody else, this is what Jesus has done for me. This is what he can do for you as well. Thirdly, Jesus is the source of our power. He's the source of your power. He is my Lord. He is my example. He is the source of my power. Some years ago, I read a news item about a man whose car engine was missing. Now, in this day and age, that's something that we hear quite often. I mean that they literally came in the night and took his entire engine away and closed the bonnet. The next morning, he got to his car with his key and he turned and nothing happened. His engine had been stolen. The power was gone. Friends, Jesus Christ is our power. He's the source of our power. Paul says, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me in Philippians 4:13. And so nobody can steal that engine that you have. They can come and, you know, I've seen people chaining their cars and doing all kinds of things to protect their vehicles. I was parked next to a vehicle even yesterday where they had this clamp on the steering. You know, I look at all of these things, but our crooks are so professional today. You can do anything and they can break through it. But when you have Jesus, he can take care of you. He can take care of your possessions. He's the source of our power. He's my Lord. He's my example. He's the source of my power. Some years ago, we have seen the transition from some years ago to today. Well, I was on a flight and the pilot came on the intercom and he gave a lot of statistics about the engine and how fast the engine goes. And he says, well, I want you to know this engine travels at over 600 kilometers an hour. But right now we are doing 750 kilometers an hour. And I thought, wow, if this engine is built to do 600 kilometers an hour, how's it doing 750? I'd like to know, because I'd like to drive fast and the engine capacity is limited. How can I go faster than that? Well, I got the answer. He said, as he spoke to everybody on the intercom, he said, we have a tailwind boosting us. So in other words, the wind was blowing fast from behind. So this plane, although it could only travel at 600 kilometers an hour, was doing 750 because the wind was carrying it. It was using less fuel. It would get to its destination faster. And so everybody is smiling all the way. Folks, there are times when I've tried my best, put my best, but it just wasn't enough. But then something above and beyond my power picked me up and gave me the power to propel me to where I needed to be. How often it looked like a hopeless situation. We can't do it, we can't have it, the monies didn't come. But suddenly, a power greater than my engine capacity will pick me up and push me forward. And I know it was the Lord. He is my Lord. He is my example. He's the source of my power. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. You can say that too. You can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. We're looking at the word impossible. A lot of people say it's impossible. It's impossible for me. You know, I looked at the word impossible and I realized there's no word such as impossible. The word impossible is really I'm possible. Look at the word impossible and just break it up. I am. I'm possible. I'm possible. There's no impossibilities in your life hereafter. When anybody and anything comes up against you and say it's impossible, say no, I'm possible. That's what the word is really. I see something else when I see that word. I'm possible. Why? I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. He is my defender and intercessor. The Apostle John wrote in 1 John chapter 2 and verse 1, my dear children, I write this to you so that you will not sin. But if anybody does sin, we have one who speaks to the Father in our defense, Jesus Christ, the righteous one. In Hebrews 7 and verse 25, therefore, he is able to save completely those who come to God through him, because he always lives to intercede for them. Christ is my defender and my intercessor. Long, long ago, David wrote these words about the love and care of God. And he said in Psalms 40 and verse 2, he lifted me out of the slimy pit, out of the mud and mire, and he set my foot on a rock, and he gave me a firm place to stand. Oh, that's what the Lord wants to do for you today. If where you're standing is slimy and slippery, and it seems like you're going down, he can take you out of there and put you on solid ground. Christ is my example, the source of my power, is my defender and my intercessor. Christ is my Führer, he is my Lord. Is he yours? Is he sovereign in your life? When he's sovereign in your life, you too can say like David, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. I don't have any needs because the Lord supplies everything for me. A number of years ago, a preacher by the name of Lockridge, he prepared a sermon that he titled, That's My King. That's My King. He had a very amazing way with words, and I'd like to just share with you a little part of it to you this morning. My King was born king. The Bible says he's a seven-way king. He's king of the Jews, that's an ethnic king. He's king of Israel, that's a national king. He's the king of righteousness, he's the king of the ages. He's the king of heaven, he's the king of glory. He's the king of kings and the Lord of lords. That's my king. That was a good place to say amen. Amen.
Amen.
That's my king. We're not worried about any earthly kings. That's my king. I wonder, do you know him? He went on to say, my king is a sovereign king. He is enduringly strong. He is entirely sincere. He is eternally steadfast. He is imperially powerful. He is impartially merciful. That's my king. He's God's son. He's a sinner savior. He's the centerpiece of civilization. He's unique. He's unparalleled. He's unprecedented. He's preeminent. I wonder if you know him today. He's the miracle of the ages. He supplies strength to the weak. He sympathizes and he saves. He guards and he guides. He heals the sick and he cleanses the lepers. He forgives sinners and delivers the captives. He blesses the young and defends the feeble. He regards the aged and rewards the diligent. That's my king. Do you know him? Well, my king is a doorway of deliverance. He's the roadway of righteousness. He's the pathway of peace. He's the highway of holiness. He's the gateway of glory. His light is matchless. His goodness is limitless. His mercy is everlasting. His love never fails. That's my King.
Hallelujah.
His word is enough. His grace is enough. His reign is righteous. His yoke is easy. And his burden is light. I wish I could describe him to you, but he is indescribable. He is incomprehensible. He is invincible. And he is irresistible. That's my King. The heavens can't contain him. Man cannot explain him. The Pharisees, they couldn't stand him. Pilate could find no fault in him. Herod couldn't kill him. Death couldn't handle him. And the grave couldn't hold him. That's my King. He was in the beginning of all things. He has always been, and he will always be. David said, the heavens declare his glory, and the firmament shows his handiwork. And he's my Savior, my King. Praise the Lord. I am his, and he is mine. Do you know him? Oh, won't you come to him today? Won't you receive him as your Lord and God? He's my King. My brothers and sisters, this is personal. You can live a happy, rejoicing life when you know Jesus to be your Lord and your Savior and your King.
Amen.
You would no more walk apologetically or talk apologetically because you know who you are in Christ. Do you know who you are? You're related to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Speak like it. Walk like it. Talk like it. And receive him in your hearts today as your Lord and as your God. Shall we pray?